Hello, aspirants. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 20th October, on the front page you have this news: 61 dead as train mows down Dasera crowd in Amritsar. So here revelers were watching burning of the Ravana effigy and they spill onto the railway tracks. And because of this, the train mowed them down. At least 60 people have been killed and 72 injured. Then next is chaos reigns at Sabarimala as protesters block women. So temple entry attempt has been abandoned on the advice of the police now because protesters are blocking women here forcefully. Then this is prepare for Ram temple, says Adityanath. So Uttar Pradesh chief minister, he says without Lord Ram, the path of public welfare will not be complete. Then on page 3, you have this news after Allahabad renaming Faizabad on VHP radar. So they seek renaming of the Uttar Pradesh city Faizabad to Sri Ayodhya. Then on page 7, you have this news. New skin gel protects from some pesticides. So Italian researchers have developed this gel, which when applied on the skin can inhibit some pesticides from getting absorbed into the body. So tests have been conducted on rats and human trials will take place soon. And this is HAL faces grim scenario as it has no new orders. So this is regarding Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. It has presently has no new orders now. If the Rafael deal would have been implemented as it was done through the bidding process, then HAL would be having the responsibility of developing the Rafael aircrafts in India under Make in India. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is keep the pace. So this is regarding the Sabarimala issue, that though the Supreme Court has given its verdict, still women have not been allowed entry, protesters are protesting and tension over the issue still continues. And this is Taliban surge. So this is regarding rise of Taliban in Afghanistan. Then the lead article is regarding the journalist who has disappeared, Jamal Khashoggi. You can skip this, we don't need the detail of that, we have done it in news. And this is statesmanship, not brinkmanship. So this is regarding the Kashmir policy. So BJP, it says, must revisit the pages of Kashmir's political history and avoid its maximalist approach for short-term gains. Then on Saturdays, the op-ed page has a ground zero coverage. So today the coverage is regarding the petroglyphs of Ratnagiri. So this is important from culture perspective. So this is a recent discovery of 1000 rock carvings on Maharashtra's Konkan coast. So petroglyphs, petro means rock. So crafts, carvings on rocks, they are called petroglyphs. Like petroleum, the word petro here means rock. Oleum, oleum means oil. So it is rock oil, which is called petroleum. So this petroglyphs here, they provide new insight into the early history of the region here. Then on page 10, you have this news: 5 militant women killed in Jammu and Kashmir. So this is three separate incidents which have occurred in Pulwama, in which soldiers have also been injured. Then this is bring law to build temple, Bhagwat. So this is RSS chief Mohan Bhagwat saying that temple will pave the way for oneness, atmosphere of oneness in the country. So now the temple issue has been picked up. Then on page 11, you have this news: fines fail to deter stubble burning. So first on stubble burning, fines are also imposed, but that too has not stopped farmers from burning stubble because other means are costly. So it's a costly affair even after the subsidies. So that is why they resort to stubble burning. So this is an issue which is very important, you should know about it. So it says farm equipment which can root out this practice not universally accessible despite government subsidy. Even those subsidized equipments are not available too, and even the subsidy is not sufficient because still they have to buy that equipment plus they have to bear the burden of operating it because it works on diesel. So this is there. And this is Arunachal Assam on alert after barrier breaches. So this is regarding now China cautioning India. The NDRF and SDRF, National Disaster Response Force, and SDRF, State Disaster Response Force teams are ready. The Siang River here is shown how, it has breached. The barriers are breached here. Then on international page, you have this news. Trump says it looks like Khashoggi's death. So this is regarding the journalist Jamal Khashoggi, who has disappeared, and it is feared that he has died when he entered into the consulate here as such. So this is the detail you can see here shown. Then on business page, you have this news. RBI steps in to ease NBFC woes. So this is regarding now RBI taking steps to support the NBFCs, non-banking finance companies. So RBI has decided to increase the single borrower exposure limit of banks for NBFCs which do not finance infrastructure. So it has been raised to 15% from existing 10% of their capital funds. Then this is RBI opposes move for independent payment regulatory body. So RBI has opposed any government move to have an independent payment regulatory body. So the draft proposal as such for amendment of the Payments and Settlement Systems Act of 2007 calls for such a body. Then now here you have this news, textile production picks up. So government is clearing TUFS errors, which bolsters fresh investments. So TUFS is Technology Upgradation Fund scheme. So this is an important scheme in the textile sector. You should know about it. On page 14, you have this, exporters in a spot over US move on GSP, Generalized System of Preferences. So Indian exporters are still eligible for benefits under GSP is what the ministry claims now. But then it is seen that US under the GSP, you know, it is actually not providing these benefits to Indian exporters. Then there's no news on the last page. So these are the important headlines. Thank you.